So this is what I've done to deactivate the auto stop start stuff. All right. So this ground wire. My wife is yelling at me. All right. So I made a little pin. I got a nail and coupled it inside of this little coupler here. So and then just stuck it right in this big fat white wire right here. So after, because you can't really stick one of these guys on here, and I didn't want to compromise the gauge of the wire. Focus on it. I didn't want to compromise the gauge of the wire by like cutting part of it, perhaps. So all right. So and then I just hooked into these colors. They're basically color coded. So you have brown, yellow, and green. And this is just like a little $4 connector from Lowe's that is all fuzzy right now. And there you go. So what I did was, wow, that's crap quality. All right, there you go. So what I did was I stuck a trailer hitch tester in it and then just wrapped it in electrical tape and then zip tied that puppy up here like this, and it works. So what I think I'm gonna do is, where that white wire is, I can either pull this little dude out or just put a little switch on it and just flip it whenever I want to actually tow a trailer and just let it through. But what I'm kind of thinking is it might just override it, and it might just give power to all the lights and just let it work like normal. So I'll just kind of see how that works the next time I play a trailer. I'm pretty sure it'll still feed power to all of the lights. It'll just always think there's a trailer pulling up. So I don't really tow trailers that often. So anyways, auto stop start disabled without screwing with the switch. I didn't want the light on. I didn't want it staying off like all the time or whatever whenever you bypass the switch up there. And I never used it. I don't like it. It never really got in the way, but I didn't want it to get in the way. And it's just